Hello everyone, 大家好 Welcome to Chinese with Ting. We will continue to talk about Chinese character, and today I will introduce Chinese character from four parts: history, formation, basic strokes, rules of stroke orders. After the video, if it is helpful, don't forget to give me a thumbs up and subscribe me. I will keep sharing Chinese learning tips. Okay, let's get started.
By the way, if you think my video is too slow, you can click the button here. Please remember here, like this, a setting. And you click it, you can change the speed. So here, this is a normal 1.25, 1.5 times. You can choose the speed, which is for you, if you're comfortable. Okay. History of Chinese characters. 3,600 years ago, geometric marks founded underground, which means...This part here, those marks. Then, 25,000 years ago, five figures founded on pottery, which means here. What do you think? What are they? Are they looks like farming tools? Earlier, it was no iron, so the tools looks like more original. And later on, iron appears.So the farming tools started to develop. 100 years ago, character changed from ancient type to modern type. Here, the sun. So outside one, something like a circle. And in the middle, there is one stroke to the moon. So the shape even is similar to the moon. Here, carriage. So,two wheels and one people on it. Plus the horse. Here, even the same. So the horse had here four legs and with one tail. And then, thousands of years later, for convenient reason and also everything is developing, the character also changes. The sun became this way, this way, this way, until the modern type. The moon changed to this way, this way, a little change to this way, the modern type. Carriage developing. Later on, two wheels disappeared, and then until this one, the modern vehicle, the modern way.Okay, last, the horse changed to this, the last modern type. Two, formation of Chinese characters. There are four types, pictographs, ideographs, ideographic compounds, phonetic compounds. Actually, there are six types, but the rest of two, the last two, didn't develop anything new. So what we need to learn is only four types like those. And first is pictographs. What is pictographs? Let's take a look about this mountain. Okay, this is how the mountain shape looked like. And in the ancient type Chinese character like this way. So two sides are equal and in the middle are a bit higher. Later, for the convenience reason, also the character is developing. So now this type became the modern type. This is what we currently use. Type 2, ideographs. First, what is ideographs? Pronunciation here is ben. It means root or original. Let's look at this picture. This is a tree. This is a tree pointed at this place. It means the root, original. And here, again, the tree pointed at this place. It means the end of the tree. Above, it means up or top. Down, pointed at the down, so it means down or under. Among all Chinese characters, ideographs is a small category. Type 3, ideographic compounds. It is always one part plus another part, sometimes three parts. We take a look. First one is 人, it means a person plus a 木, this is a 木, which means a tree. So a person leaning on the tree, it means to rest. A sun plus a moon together in the sky, that's going to be very bright. The last part, picture phonetic compounds. First, the letter side, 女, female, plus 马, the sound part, became 妈, mother. So mother is female. Second, 石, which means stone, plus 马, became also 马, and it means code or number. In the ancient, people use stone to do the counting. Picture phonetic compounds among all Chinese characters is a lot, is 82% of Chinese character. We finished the history of Chinese character and four types of Chinese character. There are only two steps more, then you can start to write. Then the one before the last step is basic strokes. What does it mean? All of our character are created by this table. Let's take a look from 1 to until 18. Until 18. Then, what are they? Number one is 横. 横, we call the stroke, the one line, we call it 横, and this is from left to right. 2, 横折. 横折. Well, okay. After 横, we have to turn to this way. Okay, 横折. Rules of stroke orders in general. Together, there are 8 types. It means 8 regulation. From top to bottom, from left to right. This order form helps us to write Chinese characters properly. Also, if you follow the regulation, you won't lose any strokes during the writing. Now let's take a look how they really works. First, from top to bottom. Okay. From top to bottom. Top, middle, and bottom. It means from top to bottom. Then, from left to right. Okay. Left and right. From left to right. 3. Horizontal before vertical. Okay, first, horizontal before and vertical. Okay. 4. Middle before sides. Okay, middle before sides. Middle, then sides. Next. From outside to inside. Okay, outside. Outside and inside. Then, inside before sealing the box. Okay, inside before sealing the box. First, we make a box and inside and seal it. 7. Box before the cutting stroke. Okay. Box again, a smaller box and cutting. Okay. The last one, cutting stroke before the last horizontal stroke. Okay. Let's take a look at this structure. First, a still from top to bottom. Okay, from top. But before the next button, the last button, we cut and the bottom in this way. Okay.